This problem dealt with the determination of hydrostatic force on a curved surface. Figure shows a long solid cylinder of radius 0.8 meter hinged at the point A is used as an automatic gate. So when the water level reaches 5 meter, the gate opens by turning about the hinge at the point A. So we have to determine the hydrostatic force acting on the cylinder and its line of action when the gate opens. The second part of the problem is we have to calculate the weight of the cylinder per meter length of the cylinder. Before starting the problem, we have to assume that the friction at the hinge is negligible and atmosphere pressure act on both sides of the gate and thus it cancels out. So we are interested to determine the hydrostatic force acting on this curved surface AC. So in the case of plane surfaces which are immersed under water, the forces produced by the fluid pressure on the small elements will be parallel. But in the case of curved surfaces, the forces produced by the fluid pressure on the small elements making up this area will not be parallel and must be combined vectorially. It is convenient to calculate the horizontal and vertical components. So this pressure force which is acting normal to the surface, but it makes an angle theta with respect to horizontal. So we have to resolve into horizontal component and vertical component. Weight of the cylinder that is acting downward through the center. So how will you find out the horizontal component and vertical component? So for which we have to project this curved surface vertically and horizontally. AC is this curved surface. So PH is acting on this vertical plane, that is horizontal projection of AC upon a vertical plane, whereas PV that is acting on the vertical projection of this curved AC upon a horizontal plane. So PH is acting on this vertical plane, whereas PV that is acting on this horizontal plane. Weight of the fluid that is enclosed within this area that is acting down. WF indicate weight of this fluid within this area. Now consider the free body diagram of fluid underneath the cylinder. PH is the horizontal component and PV is the vertical component. So PH means the hydrostatic force that is acting on this vertical plane. Since it is a vertical plane, pressure varies from point to point when we move down. So if we are moving from top to bottom, pressure increases as indicated in this pressure diagram. The area of the pressure diagram which indicates the horizontal component per unit length. Vertical component of this resultant hydrostatic force is the weight of the water, or it is hydrostatic force that is acting on this horizontal plane. So hydrostatic force means equal to the force correspond to 5 meter height of water, but it is acting in the upward direction, and weight of the fluid enclosed in this area that is acting down. So we can calculate pH equal to, either you can calculate as area of the pressure diagram which indicates the hydrostatic force per unit length multiplied with the length of this gate, or we can calculate as horizontal force on vertical surface equal to rho g into A into h bar. So rho g indicates the specific weight of water, A is the area, and h bar is the position of the center of gravity of this plane with respect to free surface. So this height that is equal to 0.8, and we can consider unit length of the gate. So area equal to 0.8 into 1. The density of water is 1000. So 1000 into 9.81 indicates specific weight of water multiplied with area multiplied with h bar. H bar is the distance of the center of gravity of this plane with respect to the free surface. So it is equal to 4.2 plus 0.8 by 2. So pH equal to 36.1 kN that is acting in the horizontal direction. Now vertical force that is acting on this horizontal surface equal to the average pressure multiplied with the area. This gate opens when the water level reaches 5 meter. So average pressure equal to specific weight into 5, that is the maximum height of water into area. So that is equal to 39.2 kN. So this represents average pressure multiplied with the area, but it is acting in the upward direction. PV is upward, so it is in the upward direction. Another vertical force is weight of the water that is within this area that is acting downward. So this area can be calculated as this side is R and this is also equal to R. So R square minus quarter area of the circle will give you the area which is enclosed. So this R square minus pi R square by 4 represents this area, or this area into 1 will give you the volume. So this represents the volume multiplied with the specific weight will represents the weight of the fluid that is acting downward. So net vertical force that is equal to, we can represent that as PVN equal to PV minus WF that is equal to 37.86 kN. Horizontal component of resultant hydrostatic force equal to 36.1 kN and the vertical component that is equal to 37.86 kN. So resultant hydrostatic force that is equal to root of PH square plus PVN square, so that is equal to 52.3 kN. So hydrostatic force acting on the cylinder equal to 52.3 kN. Now next step is to calculate its line of action. So tan theta that is equal to PVN by PH equal to 1.05 or theta equal to 46.4 degree. So how to calculate the resultant hydrostatic force and its line of action is explained in this video. So you can refer this or you can check by your own. The next step of the calculation is the weight of the cylinder per meter length of the cylinder. When the water level reaches 5 meter, the gate is about to open. The reaction force at the bottom of the cylinder equal to 0. Then the forces other than those acting at the hinge are weight of the cylinder that is acting down through its center and hydrostatic force exerted by water. Taking moment about A that is at the location of the hinge and equating it to 0, PR into R sin theta minus weight of the cylinder into R equal to 0 or weight of the cylinder equal to 37.9 kN. Weight of the cylinder equal to 37.9 kN, which is equal to net upward force. Whenever we are calculating the hydrostatic force acting on a curved surface, we have to be careful about the direction of the forces. For the time being, it is enough. Thank you.